savoir. The slings and arrows of outrageous fortune. Or to take arms against a sea of troubles. End up losing in them. To die. To sleep no more. In my sleep, to save me in the heartache and the thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. Tis a consummation devoutly to be wished. To die, to sleep. To sleep, perchance to dream. Aye, there's the rub. For in that sleep of death, what dreams may come? We have shuffled off that mortal coil. Must give us pause. There's the respect that makes calamity of so long life. For who would bear the whips and scorns of time? The oppressor's wrong, and the proud man's doom. The pangs of despised love, the law's delay, the insolence of office, and the spurns that patient merit of the unworthy takes, when he himself might his quietest make. With a bare bodkin? Who would follow's bed? To grunt and sweat under an unwearied life? But that dread of something after death. The undiscovered country, from whose bourne no traveler returns, puzzles the will and makes us rather bear those ill we have than fly to others that we know not of. Thus conscience does make cowards of us all. And thus the native hue of resolution is sicklied o'er with the pale cast of thought, and enterprises with great pith and moment. With this regard, their currents turn awry. The fair Ophelia, nymph in thy horizons, be all my sins remembered.
Say.